I really like the city. I thought that maybe that could be a place where I could live, like the architecture is very nice, the tall buildings, especially in old center, not in the new areas when there are newer buildings, but in the old center, it's very appealing as a city. And the close, the sea is close. Yeah.
The feeling was like a very big city with a lot of noise, a lot of cars. It was like, okay.
Da turista penso che Palermo sia spettacolare, perché ogni volta che la guardo, guardo la cattedrale, il Teatro Massimo, il Politeama, mi dico, noi abbiamo un patrimonio culturale così forte.
Foro Italico is this big park with I don't know how to say, lungomare, this path next to the sea. It's not a beach, you cannot swim here, but it's like a small piece of sea for you. It's very nice. I really love this place because you can find people doing sports, only with being with friends, chatting. It's very nice, very comfortable. Sometimes I come here for running, also for doing yoga. But sometimes I like to come here only for stay and relax, read, maybe write, or do nothing. Dolce far niente. I come here to run and do yoga, but what I really like is to come here for a beer and chips. And for me, it's that, well, I need in the city to have a place, a green and open air space where you can breathe. Because normally in city everything is close, like claustrophobic a little, and also gray and without color and without nature. For me it's very, very important to have this place. You can find your small piece in Foro Italico.
Il porto, the place in which the boats arrived. How do you say it in English?
The harbor.
Harbor, the harbor of Palermo. That is not so, you know, beautiful, the best thing in Palermo, but it's because Palermo is a word that came from Panormus, that means port, harbor. A place in which you can arrive and you will be, you know, you will be welcome, something like this. And also because, of course, Palermo lived by his harbor. Everything it started from the harbor. Arabians went by the ships and came from the harbor. Norway population came from the harbor. Everything born from there, and also of course the fishing. Most people, of course not now, but in the past, they lived thanks to the harbor for the commerce, for the fishing. And another thing that I like so much in Palermo is that if you are in Corso Vittorio Emanuele, sorry, and you put yourself in the center, in the four cans, you can look at your left and or right, and you will see the mountain, Monte Pellegrino. And if you go to your left side, you can see the harbor, the sea. So you are in the perfect center of these two symbols of Palermo. There is the sea, Monte Pellegrino, of course. But the harbor is the most symbolic thing in Palermo, I think. For me, it's Palermo, because everything it started from the harbor.
The last part of the statues represent the saints that protect Palermo.
So Santa Rosalia, Sant'Agata, and the other two I don't remember, sorry. But yeah, there is the Piazza Pretoria, that is my favorite square in Palermo. And also my university.
Is that what I want to do?
Something that symbolizes Palermo.
Palermo is very complex, very diverse, at the same time it's contradictory by itself.
Il genio di Palermo siamo tutti noi. Il genio di Palermo è qualunque persona che si trovi a Palermo per un qualunque motivo. Quindi quello che può essere il simbolo di Palermo è che invece di essere una grande mela, dove le persone vanno lì per realizzare i propri sogni e quindi mangiare un pezzo della mela, Palermo è più una cesta di mele, dove sì, puoi arrivare e puoi mangiare, puoi realizzare tutto ciò che vuoi, hai la libertà di farlo, ma soprattutto hai un obbligo morale di lasciare tu qualcosa alla città, di lasciare anche tu una mela, perché poi chi verrà la mangi e trovi ispirazione. Quindi penso che sia questo il simbolo di Palermo.
Palermo è troppo. Non esiste un posto che possa racchiudere l'essenza di Palermo. Palermo è tutto. Ah, ok. Palermo, allora, intanto dobbiamo parlare, se dobbiamo parlare di cibo, delle nonne. Grazie a Dio, davvero, che hanno creato queste creature fantastiche, le nonne. Per noi il cibo è molto importante, il cibo è aggregazione, è comunione, è un insieme. Quando si mangia tutti assieme, quando si finisce tutti assieme. C'è sempre il commentino, poi, ed è fondamentale il cibo per noi siciliani.
Well, no, the first impression for me about Palermitan people, or what I see in these 2 months and a half that I'm here, it's like very kind, very close people who host you and welcome in an amazing way. Very easily they ask you to go out, to go here, and they share and like invite you to eat. Always the food is the the heart of Palermo is not the place, is thing, is the food. And it's the motor, what moves what moves Palermo.
When you think about the food, I like, there's like my one favorite place for the food, not for the old food, but if you think about very Sicilian thing, which is panin con milza, and it's Nino Malerino. But then we can say that it's very like very popular, that like people from like lower level of like society, like everybody can go there, but it's like the best place to eat this this food there. But as well, the seafoods are very reachable here. They're fresh, and you can eat them really, really often, which is impossible in Poland. This is pasta con cotta e pomodoro, and this is cotta, and this is vongola, and it's very typical. And then it's like what I was saying, the part of the frutti di mare of Palermo.
Palermo, I think, just because I don't know, in our, I think that in our blood it's something that make as open-minded and ready to welcome every different culture that come here. I will tell you that I think that this town is so rich and so full of colors and different habits and different way of life, also for these things, because we are everything. Every culture passed by here in the town, Greek, Latin, Arabians, Norway, Spanish, also the Bourbon went here in Palermo and make the two Sicily rain. So it's like I want to reject a cousin, a familiar, a parent, I don't know, something like this.
La differenza etnica e culturale poi alla fine è scema, finisce, non esiste più, perché io ho visto ballare persone di differenze, cioè di differenti culture, le ho viste mangiare assieme, le ho viste andare al cinema, farsi concerti, quindi forse proprio a Palermo questo discorso non si adatta molto.
Just come here and be part of Palermo.
What do you think?
No, the first answer I would say it would be Sicilian, I think, obviously, because it's I think that the belonging it's based on cultural issues, and some characteristic of my cultural traditions are just older than Italy in general. Let's say that in my feeling Sicilian, I feel closer to Europe as a concept than to the Italian nation, probably.
And where is Paul feeling of being Polish in this group?
It wasn't in the question there.
Well, you can answer.
It's in the Europeans, I think, no? I think that I spent 1 year, thanks to Ivy, in Poland and Warsaw especially, as well contributed very much to this feeling that now I feel toward like a European identity, let's say.
Yeah, for me, definitely Sicilian. Maybe also because I am Catalan. And I feel this specific identity.
So thinking about being European, you feel even more Sicilian than European?
Yes, because I don't like this category. Imagine European. How can we talk about being European? What does it mean to be European? Who describes, who says what is the normal European person? Because we have a lot of differences, very different identities, also inside every region and every area. And our identity is crossed by a lot of different things, not only the place you live. So for me it's so hard, and I don't like these very big categories or labels.
There are differences. No, I guess, like the gene differences.
Yeah, but in the meaning, I mean, like we are really different within each other. Because it's important.
We are different and we are similar. Like, okay, so we are that similar, really? If you're asking
that's
me, we're really different between
that's
each other?
According to what you feel, I think, how... Of course it doesn't exist any, in this moment, European identity or common, like, spread and shared. Of course it doesn't. But as probably in Germany wasn't existing a German identity before they got united, for example. And that's, I think, when identity it's coming out is when the population or the people in general, they get to know, they in some way mix, and they understand how it's can be important and enriching any kind of cultural diversity. Because if I should feel like according to my cultural diversity or cultural belonging or root, I feel Sicilian. But if I want to extend this concept to people with whom I share in general values and thoughts about life, I feel not even European, I can feel as well international in some way. So that's...
Like if you think about this way, it's more like you are the citizen of the globe, not
sure,
you.
Of course.
Non mi vedo come nessuno dei tre, sinceramente, perché sono nata in Venezuela e quindi sento che una parte di me è venezuelana. Sento che un'altra parte di me è siciliana, senza dubbio, sì, e probabilmente la mia formazione e il mio modo di pensare è molto europeo. Però non mi sento veramente venezuelano o siciliano o italiano o europeo. Sento che sono più un essere umano che vive nel suo pianeta. Quindi penso più un cittadino del mondo.
Okay, so for me social inclusion is a kind of social integration with the acceptance of each other and exchange on different levels, but with the base of our identity, our habits, traditions and worldviews. And through this we can create a new common value and try to understand each other and feel valued and important.
La inclusione sociale per me. Allora, per me, come dico sempre, è prima di tutto avere rispetto verso l'altra cultura, quindi accettare che l'altra persona sia tra virgolette diverse, che l'altra persona sia diversa da noi, pensando sempre che siamo noi in realtà i diversi. Quindi penso che per me è importante innanzitutto pormi delle domande e vedere l'altro come una fonte di ispirazione diversa, come una fonte dalla quale posso imparare qualcosa che altrimenti non saprei. Perché è vero che viaggiando puoi conoscere tantissimi posti, puoi capire tantissimo della cultura, però è solo incontrando la gente e parlando con loro che puoi veramente capire quelli che sono le fondamenta del loro pensiero e della loro, tra virgolette, sempre diversità. Quindi l'inclusione sociale, dicevo, innanzitutto è il rispetto. Dopodiché è apertura, quindi non aver paura ad aprirsi all'altro, ad aprirsi a ciò che l'altro ha da dire, ciò che l'altro pensa, e soprattutto una volta che ti sei aperto, ascoltare, quindi non avere pregiudizi, non giudicare mai qualcuno, ma semplicemente ascoltare per il piacere di ascoltare e di imparare. Quindi sicuramente è un processo. La social inclusion è sicuramente un processo che innanzitutto parte da noi e che poi si può far trasparire in qualcos'altro o in cose più grandi. Cos'altro potrebbe essere per me? Sì, penso sia questo. Rispetto, apertura, non giudicare, no pregiudizi, e invece imparare e vivere il momento.